Hello students, so up till now we seen the four types. So today we will discuss about the type 5, fifth type. So in fifth type, our topic is subcooling, or it is also known as undercooling. So you can see in the diagram. So first of all, we will try to understand that what is undercooling. So here you can see in the diagram that suppose this is our refrigerant and we have compressed that refrigerant from 1 to 2. Now then after our refrigerant pass from the condenser. Now in condenser what we are doing? We are converting that vapor into liquid. Clear? Up to its saturation temperature. We are just cooling it, or we are just converting that vapor into liquid, but we are just reducing its temperature up to T saturated only. Suppose here our we will assume, suppose our T saturation temperature is 30 degree. Let us assume that this is 30 degree. Clear? And suppose here we have assumed it is 50. So what happened here? First of all, we have compressed the refrigerant up to 50 degree. Then from 50 degree, first of all we have reduced the temperature, and then after we have converted that vapor into liquid, and after that liquid get converted, we directly send that liquid into expansion valve or throttling device. Clear? But this is known as our normal expansion. Clear? But subcooling means if you will reduce the temperature in condenser or after the condenser below saturation temperature. So here you can see that we have just we haven't cooled refrigerant only up to 30, but we have reduced it up to point number 3. Let us assume it as a 25 degree centigrade. So I hope you have understood this. So in general, in normal case, what we were doing in previous four cases, we were just cooling our refrigerant up to saturation temperature only. But here, if you will cool your refrigerant below saturation temperature, so that is known as subcooling. So here, how much degree of subcooling we have? We have 5 degree of subcooling. Degree of undercooling or subcooling, 5 degree. Why 5 degree? Because what is the difference between these? 30 and 25, difference is 5 degree. That's why it is known as 5 degree of undercooling or 5 degree of subcooling. So I hope you have understood this. Now in that, this point may be anywhere. This point number 1 and point number 2 is not of that much importance in this case. Clear? Now this point may be superheated, this point may be superheated or outside this, or this point may be wet. That is not our area of interest in this case, particularly in this case. In this case, our focus is basically on which point? Point number 3 and point number 4. Our interest is on point number 3-4-3-4. Our focus is not on these two points. So let us assume that our our point number 1 is dry saturated. So obviously our point number 2 would be superheated. So this is our assumption. This is just our assumption. Here it may be any, this point may be anywhere, we do not know, but for easy solution, we have assumed that this is dry saturated and 2 is superheated. So now, how to find out enthalpy? So one of the enthalpy we can find out easily, and that is H1. So can you estimate what would be the equation? Here it would be Hg. Clear? Hg. At which pressure? Obviously evaporator pressure, it would be Hg at evaporator pressure. So it is easy, we can easily find out H1. And here also we can find out H2. What would be the equation of H2? We all know what is the equation of H2. Hg plus CpV, T superheated condenser minus T saturated condenser. Clear? So these would be the equation, and all the value you have to take at which pressure? You have to take at P condenser. But here condition is that this should be given to us, this should be available, or this should be given in the example, T superheated condenser, then we can find out H2. Otherwise it would be difficult, procedure will become lengthy. Clear? So two enthalpy we can find out, H1 and H2. Formula are there with us, so we can find out that. Now how can we find H3 and H4? But before that, before finding H3 and H4, you need to find out this. You have to find out this H3 dash. Now formula of H3 dash is simple. H3 dash is HF at which pressure? P condenser. Clear? Now H3 is equal to H3 dash minus CPL and degree of undercooling. Clear? So what is degree of undercooling? I told you what is degree of undercooling, and CPL would be given to you in the example. Clear? So this is how we can find out H3. So here I have written procedure. This should be the procedure. First of all you have to find out H3 dash, and then after, from H3 dash, you have to put this value here and you can find out H3. Now then after, no need to find out H4, because we know that H3 is equal to H4. So this is the procedure to find out the enthalpy in our fifth case. Now again let us read this. So I told you H1 is easy. H1 is equal to Hg at P evaporator. S1 is equal to, okay. So if these two, T superheated not given, if T superheated not given, so what we have to do? So we all know that first of all we have to find out S1, then after we have to find out S2, then after we have to find out T superheated condenser if not given, and then after we can find out H2. This is the procedure. So that procedure also written here. So here you can see that S1, S2, then after S2, find T superheated condenser, and then after H2. Clear? So if T superheated condenser not given, then our procedure would become lengthy. So this is the procedure to find out H2. So let us try one example. So here I hope you have understood this. So how to find out 4 enthalpy? So this is the method to find out H3. This is the method we can find out H4. This is the way how we can find out H1. And what is remaining? H2 is remaining. So finally, this is the equation we can utilize to find out H2. Clear? Now let us solve one numerical. So if ECR use R12 as refrigerant and the liquid evaporates in the evaporator at minus 15, the temperature of the refrigerant at the delivery from the compressor is 15. When the vapor is condensed at 10, find COP if the liquid is cooled by 5 degree. So many temperatures are given. So we got confused. So let us draw the diagram. So by use of diagram, it would be easy to understand. So here you can see, let me zoom this. So you can see here, this is our temperature 10 degree. this is our temperature minus 15. So this is T saturated condenser, this is T saturated evaporator, clear? This is our temperature 15 after compressor, and here it is told that 5 degree subcooling. So obviously our 10 minus 5, so this will be 5 degree, clear? So do not confuse here. If 3 degree subcooling would be given, then here we would have 7 degree centigrade, clear? Agar 3 degree subcooling diya hota to yahan pe kitna aur aayega hamara temperature 7 degree aa jata, clear? If here 5 degree subcooling is given, that's why here our temperature is 5 degree centigrade, clear? Now let us start the example. So as I told you, first of all we need to find out H3 dash. So this is the H3 dash. What is the formula that we know? HF, at which pressure? At which pressure? Pre-condenser pressure. HF at which pre-condenser. So simple. So let us check that. So this is our pre-condenser pressure. Now here remember, higher temperature is given. That's why higher temperature means condenser. So what is HF here? 45.4. So let us check that. 45.4, simple. Then after, as I told you, that this is the equation for find out H3 dash minus CPL and undercooling, degree of undercooling or degree of subcooling. Now CPL, is it given in the data? Let us check. Okay, so here you can see CPL is given 0.94. So that we return that CPL and we can find out H3. Now here also entropy will not come in picture, because temperature, all the temperature given, so no need to calculate the entropy. Now then after H4 you can easily find, we know that H4 is equal to H3. Now H1 is equal to Hg. H1 is equal to Hg, but at which pressure? Now here also I am not writing all the time pressure, because you all know that P evaporator pressure, Hg. Let us check that. Let us check Hg. Evaporator means this is the evaporator, and what is Hg? 180.88. So let us check that. 180.88. Okay, now H2. So simple formula for H2, we know that for H2 what is the formula? Hg plus CpV T superheated condenser minus T saturated condenser, clear? Now here what is T superheated condenser? 15 degree. This is our 15 degree. And what is T saturated condenser? It is basically our 10 degree. So let us check that what is written here. So as I told you that this is 15, this is 10. So here directly difference is written 5 degree. And CPV is also given, H2. Clear? So for H2, which pressure you have to utilize? P condenser, all the value. Now here you can find out H2, and finally put all the value in the equation of COP and you can find out COP. So I hope you have understood this. So thank you all for listening me.